Welcome to Beyond Bee's Christmas Special Let's Build and opening of Advent Calendars. This is the first of our pre-recorded episodes. But let's just jump right into it and let's get opening some Advent Calendars. So, here's the overhead. Let's move all this to the side and bring up Lego City and find number 5. This right here, and it is a train, and it looks like it is one of those fast moving trains. We are building first. And see if we can do it better than we did yesterday with me building things wrong. Nope, I start out with building things wrong, so it is a good start on that part. We have the main part with the roller skates down under, and here we have train car with the roller skates down under. Then the wagon needs to have those two, and the locomotive only needs this one, and then this one, and then we can move up, placing this one here. Nope. This one has to. This one has to go here. This one has to go there. Let me place this one here, so we can link them together into one unit. And a red light on the back. Then we can put the front on the train here. And we have placed another window. Then we can put this one on here. This one on top. And there we have it, a train! Ready for the Christmas shoppers that has to go into the big town and shop a lot of Christmas gifts. And we can go to the Harry Potter one. Four. And number 5 is here. Do we have today? Good question. Oh, I think it is maybe the entrance to the Slithering common room. That is what I think it is. It is my idea of what we have today. Sorry about that. The quarter circles. Here we have the other quarter circles. Then we take a red one into the middle. It is all technic part. Yeah. And then we place a snake head in the middle. This one. Then we have this
one we have to place here, so this might have to kind of... Oh, we need to place
this one before.
Then we can put it into here. Here, one thing down from it, and there you have it. Whatever this is, it looks like this.
Maybe it is meant to be Salazar Slytherin with the snake coming out of the mouth. I think it is what it is trying to look like. Let's get back to our house. But yesterday, I actually forgot to read the small anecdote from Lego. So let's just get to that today. Part 49307 is something unofficially called the Bread Loaf by Lego designers. And here is actually used to create a loaf of bread. So I was right yesterday when I say it was a loaf of bread we had built in the kitchen. Just turn it around here, and I think we once more move to this camera here so we can see what we are building. With, some greenery here. A bit of greenery this way, greenery the other way. And then two green ones and two cherries, just to get a little bit of red inside also. Two cherries. You can put them down here. You can just turn it so we can see that part. And here we have to make one with just the green ones part into it. Then we have to place inside here. And then we make another one here. We have to take this one that is longest that way, put this one into. And then put this one here. And then take another cherry to put the cherry on the top. And then place it like this.
like this. And then we can move over to the other side and do it once more. Just for the funsies of doing it one more time. So one here. And then here we have to do it on the other side, just so we can, when we put it, place it here, we can get the cherry in the middle. And we have to place this one so it kind of waves outwards. Yeah. Cherry kind of also waving a little bit outwards. And then we can place it here. And then we also have to kind of get this one like this. And that was the red and green. So we have to build something. Windowsill, is that is what is, I think it is called. Please don't picture me in the chat for my pronunciation. And then a dove, I think it is. Anyway, a small bird which is out in the winter time, and then we can place it in the living room part. Just have to turn the bird around because it likes to have it this way. We make another windowsill. This one is without any birds on it. Which is a kind of double windowsill. So like that. That one there. And that tells me that I might have a problem because I have a piece too much I should not have. So I just going to look back and see what I might have missed. I think I maybe have found a problem. Problem is actually the stove. I have made an error on the stove. So for everyone who actually saw I made the error, you can now relax. You don't need to comment it anymore. But yes, that. So now it is kind of more aligned with the rest of the kitchen. That means we are moving to bag number 4. So here's bag number 4. I think we went a little bit fast through bag number 3 I will say, but I think number 4 is going to take just a little bit longer than bag number 3. And let's start out. Once again, just moving around here. Maybe just move this one a little bit up. Okay, we are going to be building the back of the chimney here. Ones like this. Continue building on the chimney. Then we can continue building on the house. Expanding the house upwards. Slowly but steadily. Getting the house higher and higher. Yes, we are. One here, and then one there. And then we have built one more layer, and then we can build one more layer on that layer. So let's just start it in the other direction this time, just to do it differently. Slowly beginning to become a bigger house. We have the main part there of the chimney. We place one there, and then we have to find the two. A good lesson in if you want to be that was also I don't know what they are called. The ones who lay the bricks when you are building a house. That is a good way to learn to oscillate when you are building, because if you are only building the same way
costly, then you have a wall that cannot stand by itself. So that is why it is very important to always be oscillating when you are building. To keep on to have the strength of the build. Otherwise, the building will fall and you will be in trouble. Was not empty. I thought it was empty, but it was not empty because it had all the windows in it. Here we have a window. Let's do this. Switch over. Window there. Save window here. All those windows we are going to be placing a little bit, some of those you see in the middle helps logging in to those double windows before we then later on probably put something on top of them to totally lock them in. So we are continuing on the chimney. Just turn around again so we can turn it up over here. Overview here. Then we can begin to place things on top. You may have to place this one.
this. Up here. Six from this one over the chimney and to the chimney over to hold the other part of the wall that was already beginning to fall. And then this right here. And we can build something more around here, the chimney. Say this feeling like this is coming along very nicely. Maybe a little bit too fast. I think that is why you're awfully. Get building a Christmas door, and I almost when I will say with this Christmas door, when we have done to build that and put it into place, I think then it is time for to end the video for today. Yeah, and then we take this one. No, I'm doing it a little bit backwards. Should stay on inside there, but side of the door. So I have to go down. This one goes up, this one goes down, just so we can close the door. So it is this way inside. That's a not so beautiful part inside. Yeah. Not take the bed, but the more beautiful part outside, and then it opens inwards. As it should. So. Thank you so much for watching today's episode, and I hope to see you again tomorrow live at 1900 Central European Time CET. Until next time, just keep building!